Ventricles of the brain. What are the ventricles? They are the cavities present in the brain. Okay. There are a pair of lateral ventricles, the third ventricle and fourth ventricle. Lateral ventricles. It is the cavity present in the two cerebral hemispheres. Okay. It has a body with three projections known as anterior horn, posterior horn and inferior horn. So this is the lateral ventricle. So there are two lateral ventricles, one in each cerebral hemispheres. Interventricular foramen. It is the foramen which connects the lateral ventricle with the third ventricle. Okay. Third ventricle, it is the cavity present between the two thalamus. Two thalami. Okay, cavity present between the two thalami. Okay. It is connected to the fourth ventricle by cerebral aqueduct. Cerebral aqueduct. Fourth ventricle. It is a rhomboid-shaped cavity present between the midbrain and pons anteriorly and the cerebellum posteriorly. So this is the cerebellum. This is pons. This is middle of the neck. So this is the fourth ventricle. So it is the cavity, rhomboid shaped cavity present between the pons and the middle of the neck anteriorly and the cerebellum posteriorly. The fourth ventricle continues to the central canal of the spinal cord. Central canal of the spinal cord. Okay. The ventricles are filled with cerebrospinal fluid. Okay. The cerebrospinal fluid is produced by choroid plexus lining the interior of the ventricles. Okay. So where this cerebrospinal fluid drains? It drains in through the arachnoid granulations. They drains through the arachnoid granulations. Blood supply to the brain. Okay. The brain is supplied by two main arteries. Number one, internal carotid artery. Number two, vertebral artery. Okay. The branches from the internal carotid artery and the vertebral artery joins to form a network that is a circle known as circle of Willis or circulus arteriosus. Okay. The right and left vertebral artery joins to form the basilar artery. The branches arising from the internal carotid artery and the vertebral arteries are number 1 anterior cerebral artery, number 2 middle cerebral artery, number 3 posterior cerebral artery, number 4 anterior communicating artery and number 5 posterior communicating artery. So these are the 5 major arteries which supplies the cerebrum. Okay. Cerebellum. Definition. It is the second largest part of the brain, situated in the posterior cranial fossa. It is separated from the cerebrum by a fold of dura mater known as tentorium cerebelli. Tentorium cerebelli. General features. Parts. It consists of two cerebellar hemispheres connected in the midline by a worm-like structure known as vermes. It consists of two cerebellar hemispheres connected in the midline by a worm-like structure known as vermes. Surfaces. It has two surfaces, superior surface and inferior surface.
On the inferior surface, there is a deep median notch known as valvular fissures. There are three fissures in the cerebellum. Number one, fissura prima. Number two, horizontal fissure. Number three, posterolateral fissure. Lobes. It consists of three lobes. Number one, anterior lobe. Number two, middle or posterior lobe. Number three, flocular nodular lobe. Flocular nodular lobe. Intracerebellar nuclei. Intra means within. So the cerebellum contains nucleus. Okay. They are number one, dentate nucleus. Number two, emboliform nucleus. Number three, fastigial nucleus. Number four, globus nucleus. So D, E, F, G, dentate nucleus. D stands for dentate nucleus. E stands for emboliform nucleus. F stands for fastigial nucleus. And G stands for globus nucleus. Cerebellar peduncles. Peduncles means bundles of fibers. So the cerebellum has three cerebellar peduncles. Number one, superior cerebellar peduncle. Number two, middle cerebellar peduncle. Number three, inferior cerebellar peduncle. The superior cerebellar peduncle connects cerebellum with the midbrain. The middle cerebellar peduncle connects the cerebellum with the pons. The inferior cerebellar peduncle connects the cerebellum with the medulla oblongata. Blood supply. It is supplied by number one, superior cerebellar artery. Number two, anterior inferior cerebellar artery. Number three, posterior inferior cerebellar artery. So these are the arteries which supply the cerebellum. Meninges of the brain. What are meninges? They are tough fibrous membrane which encloses and protects the brain and spinal cord. It consists of three layers. Okay. Pia matter, arachnoid matter, dura matter. PAD, pad. Pia matter, arachnoid matter, dura matter. Pia matter is the inner, okay, most layer which is adherent to the surface of the, okay, brain. Arachnoid matter is the middle layer. Okay, on the surface of the arachnoid matter, you can see arachnoid granulations which drains the CSF. Dura matter, it is the outermost layer which is very tough. And it is made up of two layers, okay, endosteal layer and meningeal layer. Okay, the endosteal layer, okay, in some certain areas it splits, again it unites. So wherever it splits and unites, it forms a space. Okay, so that is the space which is filled with venous blood. Dural venous sinuses. They are the space present between the two layers of the dura matter which are filled with venous blood. The dural venous sinuses are number one, superior sagittal sinus. Number two, inferior sagittal sinus. Number three, straight sinus. Number four, right and left transverse sinus. Number five, right and left sigmoid sinus. Number six, right and left superior petrosal sinus. Number seven, right and left inferior precursor sinus. Number 8, right and left cavernous sinus. So first three are unpaired, okay, dural venous sinuses. The remaining are paired dural venous sinuses. So where all these dural venous sinuses drain? They drain into the internal jugular vein. So finally all the dural venous sinuses drains into internal jugular vein. What is the importance of dural venous sinuses? Okay, see, there is a blood supply from the brain which is supplied by the arteries. So the veins of the brain, that is the veins which drain the deoxygenated blood from the brain, okay, drains into dural venous sinuses. Okay, the dural venous sinuses are connected to the veins, the superficial veins present in the skull by emissary veins. Emissary veins. So infections from the superficial veins can enter into the brain through the emissary veins and dural venous sinuses, and it may cause infections.